Narasimhan is considered as father of banking reforms in India. His demise has been really hurtful for many of us, and today we will be talking about his two major reforms. So it were in the name of Narasimhan Committee 1 reforms and the Narasimhan Committee 2 reforms, and we would be talking about those today. His reforms in banking sector revolutionized the way the banking works. He was also the founder of the credit cell, the credit planning cell of RBI, which later turned into the monetary policy department. Now, let's first talk about his committee 1 reforms, which were the 1991 reforms. What was the objective? The idea was to bring in more flexibility, more autonomy in the decision making process in banking sector, and bring in more professionalism and competitiveness with the banking sector, creating an efficient and an effective banking framework. So what were his recommendations? His banking reforms 1991 had certain important recommendations. His idea was there would be a 4-tier hierarchy in the banking, with SBI on the top and 3-4 banks on the top. Next to it, there would be 8 to 10 national banks. Below it, there would be the local banks, and he also focused on RRBs and strengthening of the regional rural banks. Also, he believed that private banks should be at par with the public banks. So, any ban to set up new private banks should be immediately removed, and all licenses that are required for expanding the branches of private banks should be abolished. Foreign banks should be allowed to come to India with liberal outlook, and there should be joint venture between Indian and foreign banks. Also, the concept of NPA classification was propounded, the non-performing assets and full disclosure of accounts. Along with it, he conceptualized the term capital adequacy ratio. Not only this, he also focused on the idea to reduce the statutory liquidity ratio and the cash reserve ratio from the existing rates, which were high at around 40 and 50 in 1991-92. He deregulated the interest rate to reflect the emerging markets. Also, similar to the public sector units, the public sector banks should also be disinvested, and each public sector bank should have a responsibility to set up rural banking subsidiaries across India. Priority lending should be curtailed, and priority lending sector should be redefined. So what should be the priority sector? The priority sector should focus on marginal farmers, small business operators, tiny industrial units. But his banking reforms came up with one of the major criticisms, and that was the reduction of the SLR would affect the borrowing capacity of the government adversely, and that was one of the major criticisms that were seen. The next was his committee 2 reforms. Now, committee 2 reforms was also known as the Committee on Banking Sector Reform. It was brought into effect in 1998 after the 1991 reforms, and there were 6 points that were taken into account. The first was the capital adequacy. Now, capital adequacy, the government suggested that it should be 5% of the market risk for the government and the approved security. The non-performing assets, so what they classified as a non-performing asset was if the asset has been substandard for 18 months, then there was a leeway given for another 12 months, and even if that was not identified, then it would be classified as a non-performing asset. The idea was to reduce it to 5% in 2000 and 3% by 2002. Also, if they are working with international banks, they have to reduce it to 5% and then 3% and bring it at a net presence of 3% and 0%. So this was the gross NPA of 5% and 3%, and a net NPA of 3% and 2%. Prudential norms, the idea was to reduce it to 90 days by 2002. Now, in India, the income stops accruing when the interest rate of the principal or the interest or the installment of the principal, we could say, is not paid within 180 days. So this should be reduced to 90 days. That was his another recommendation. His next idea was to strengthen the banking system and revise the operational manuals of the banking. Now this focused on the emerging needs of the banking, the changing ideas, with more promotion to a good customer service and identifying independent loan review authority systems. The next was development finance institutions, which should be converted either into banks. So there should be nothing like DFIs. The only two category would be the banking sector or the non-banking financial corporations. So either DFI have to convert themselves into banking sector, or they would go into the category of non-banking financial companies. And the last was to facilitate more rural and small industrial credits. And with this, the rural infrastructure and the banking in the rural sectors could be enhanced. So Narasimhan committee reforms, committee 1 and committee 2 reforms, are very, very important. We have talked about the highlights of both the committees. We would be covering many more interesting topics related to economics. Stay tuned. Have a wonderful day ahead.